Hi everyone, and welcome back to our channel. In this video, we will share the key principles for developing a successful tokenomics strategy. We will touch upon the main token types, outline what makes a good tokenomics, and discuss what vital components it should have. For the finale, you will get a step-by-step guide on how to create a robust tokenomics for your project. So, grab a pen and let's get started. The first thing you need to know is, what makes good tokenomics? Here are three major points. Number one, you need to make it clear how to utilize the tokens. Users should know exactly what they can do with their tokens. Do tokens represent an investment, or can they be utilized to buy items on your platform? Make it obvious for your users. Number two, you should encourage users to utilize their tokens. Motivate users to spend their tokens rather than hoarding them, because regular transactions will safeguard liquidity of your token. For example, you can offer users to exchange their token for specific services or benefits. And number three, define tokens emission schedules. Token emission schedules can be flexible or fixed. If the schedule is flexible, you can quickly respond to market changes and prevent rapid price fluctuations. A fixed schedule is more stable for users, but this approach may result in drastic changes in price and token supply. The next crucial question that you need to understand is what token types are out there. There are four main types of crypto token: utility tokens, governance tokens, security tokens, and non-fungible tokens. Utility tokens can be exchanged for various benefits within the platform. This token type has the biggest number of possible use cases, including getting access to certain services, staking, liquidity mining, loyalty programs, and payments. Security tokens act as digitally issued financial securities and are regulated by the government. They represent a stake in an asset or enterprise. Governance tokens give users the right to propose ideas on platform development. They can also vote for or against other proposals. And last but not least, non-fungible tokens or NFTs. They can represent various assets from digital art to real estate, game artifacts, sport trophies, educational achievements, and more. If you decide to use NFTs in your project, this will mean that you will offer users unique items that they can buy, sell, or collect. You might be wondering what are the important components of tokenomics are, and here we are with the answer. There are two main components: token supply and demand. When determining token supply, you need to consider the possible change in the supply over time and how it will affect the price of your token. An increase in token circulation leads to a decrease in value and inflation. At the same time, a decrease in circulation leads to deflation, which means an increase in token value. Understanding the demand is also crucial, as it makes enormous contribution to the token value. You will need to take into account the return on investment, ROI. The ROI is expected amount of money that users will receive just by holding the token. If it doesn't pay off, people won't be interested in the project. Building and maintaining a strong community is also important, since they will create demand for the token. And finally, we got to the most important question: what are the main steps to design tokenomics? So, step one, you will need to set project goals and define token types. What are your project goals? How do you want to achieve them? What role tokenomics will play there? Answer these questions first. As for token types, here is what you will need to take into account. If you want to launch your own token, you may need to implement utility tokens. They will let user access your goods and services or make payments. If you plan to launch a DAO, you will need to introduce governance tokens to allow users to vote and propose their own ideas. If you want your tokens to represent a stake in an asset and be regulated, then security tokens are the ones to consider. If your platform is about tokenizing unique assets, then you will obviously need NFTs. All in all, the type of tokens you choose will depend on your project's characteristics and business goals. Step 2. Think through your token design. You will need to come up with the name and symbol for the token, decide on the total token supply, calculate possible token demand, and define how you will mint and distribute tokens. By the way, we will talk about the distribution of tokens in detail in our next video. Don't miss it. In the end, work with your marketing team to figure out how to attract early adopters to your platform. Then, there is step 3, where you will need to choose an economic model. Deflationary and inflationary are the two major types of token economic models. The deflationary model means that you will create a limited number of tokens. This is how Bitcoin works. There are only 21 million Bitcoins. As of March 2023, over 19 million coins had been mined, which means there are a little over 1.7 million of them left to be mined. This model creates scarcity and raises the price of the token when the supply goes down. With the inflationary model, the number of tokens is unlimited and can grow over time. Ethereum is a good example here. It is the second largest coin in the world. As of March 15, 2023, it has 122.3 million coins in circulation, and there is no max supply. Step 4. Make sure that your tokenomics model is beneficial for users. Your team will need to create solid, reliable, and attractive ways for users to benefit from their interaction with your crypto platform. This can be loyalty programs, staking pools, liquidity mining, and other approaches. Step 5. Evaluate potential flows and risks. You will need to analyze every aspect of your project's token economy and see if there are any small or big flows that can be fixed or improved. For example, you will need to check if there are any security issues. If there is a chance that tokens can be stolen, it will ruin the reputation of your project. So, audit your smart contracts and make sure they don't have bugs and vulnerabilities. And finally, step 6. Make plans for the future. Even before launching your platform, think about how your crypto tokenomics will evolve in the future. Work out the details of how your model can further add value to investors and still bring you financial benefits. Would you like to find out more about tokenomics, blockchain-based projects, and other cutting-edge technologies? Visit our blog, where we keep our audience up to date with the latest trends and provide answers to all your how-to tech-related questions. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to be the first to watch our next videos. Stay tuned for more updates. Bye!